Hello, this is Bern, and if you want to stop wasting time with men, on today's episode, I'm going to be sharing with you four things you need to know about him in order to move forward. Stick with me. Hello, this is Bern. Welcome to your greatlifetoday.com, a space where I share with ambitious, conscious, heart-centered, and successful women how you can create the relationship of your dreams and attract and sustain a relationship with the kind of man you want. It's a direct result of showing up in your most alive and most feminine version of you without the need to play games or manipulate or any crazy tricks or techniques. Now, the reason why today's theme is so important is because I see this happening so frequently. Women reach out to me for help who have a painful relationship, a major crisis in their hands, a guy that they've fallen in love with, that they've given heart and soul with, maybe they have children with, maybe they've taken it all the way, and they realize that this is not the guy that they want to be with, or that the guy has some fundamental flaws that are not a match to the kind of life she wants, or that there's some discrepancies, there's some inconsistencies in the way he shows up versus the way he said he was going to show up, number one, or number two, that there is incompatibility of the non-moving forward kind. And many of these issues could have been avoided downstream had you taken the time to understand the four fundamental forces, questions, sense of direction that I'll explain to you on this video. The first thing you need to know when you connect with a man who's interested in dating you is where he's at in life. It's like a conscious assessment, open, conscious assessment of where he's at. Why? Because where he's at is not the end all be all in the sense that he's gonna go to a different destination going forward, but it will give you a very clear picture of what he's valued, what he's gone for, where his energy has been, what his level of consciousness is, and what kind of guy he is. So where he's at in terms of his career, where he's at in terms of his relationships with people around him, where he's at in terms of past relationships with women, where he's at in terms of the kind of life that he's built for himself, the lifestyle that he's been able to step into, create, the kind of rituals he has on a day-to-day basis, on a monthly basis. All those things are important because a snapshot of his life right now, you can see a snapshot of the decisions he's made. As I said before, it doesn't mean he's going to stay there, but it means that it's going to give you a pretty good prediction of the kind of man he's been. And some women avoid looking at that, and they simply look at the future. And if you only look at the future, if you only look at men as projects, meaning the potential that they have is so great, but their present is shitty, well, you're in for a wild, painful ride because maybe unlikely that the guy will change. So that's the first thing you need to figure out. Where is he at in those categories? Number two, incredibly important, where is he headed? What are his intentions moving forward in his life? What is his feeling, his heart level feeling of relationships? What does he want? What is his vision, his ideal way of looking at life? Does he want to go for a marriage at some point? Does he want to go for a partnership where two human beings cohabitate but never get married? Does he want to live in separate houses and maybe have his mommy fold his clothes for the rest of his life and make lunch for him? it varies, right? So you need to figure out where is he headed in his career? Where is he headed in terms of the relationship he wants? You want to find out where he's headed in terms of the vision that he has for a legacy, meaning the reason why he's here. Is he aware of that? Is he aware of the reason he's alive? Is he stepping into doing something for someone else other than himself? Does he contribute in his own community? Is he interested in contributing more or maybe contributing less in the future? Those things are very, very important for you to understand. Why? Because the sense of direction that he has, the sense of clarity he has about the life that he wants to create is going to be part of what he has to offer to you. When the man either is confused about what he wants or has never even thought of it, it's not that he's confused, he just hasn't given it the time or thought, then you reaching that destination with him is possible, just like it's possible to wake up one day and maybe fall asleep on a random plane and land in your ideal destination. there's maybe one in, I don't know, a few thousand chances that that's the ideal destination, but more likely than not, you're going to arrive to a place that you don't even know, maybe it's a different continent than the one you were intending. Third thing that you need to know about a man is, now that you understand where he's at, where he's going, at which pace is he going? And this is why it's important, because if his number one thing right now, for example, is financial success, and the pace he's going at is a crazy speed, that means that he's going to probably focus mostly on that, and you might be the fourth priority in his life, if that's the case. Now, if the pace is extremely slow, then he might have a lot of time for you, but you're going to start feeling like the dude is not stepping up to do his work, not because you want him to be rich, but because you want him to stay consistent with the direction that he's headed. And that he's not the type of guy that says, well, if we got engaged for 7 years, you know, like you want a guy who, when he gets engaged 6 months later, boom, there's a wedding, right? Versus, or a year later after engagement, maximum. But you don't want a guy who's like on a 20-year plan. And the pace that he's on in different areas of his life, the urgency he has to create those things matters. The urgency he has to create a family matters. Here's why it matters, my dear, because he has the luxury, if you want to call it that, to get somebody pregnant at 90, if theoretically he could get it up, basically at 90, he could get somebody pregnant. You don't have the same luxury. You have fewer years than a man to make this type of stuff work. So if a family is important to you and his pace is far slower than yours, then that may not be the right fit for you, because you're gonna feel he's not doing his job and he's gonna feel like you always think he's doing it wrong. Fourth thing you need to know, and this is why time is so important. Time is of the essence. And I'm not just talking about time as in looking at time, but spending quality time with him, different scenarios, different days, different weeks, different months. Why? Because you need to know if the man can walk his talk. There's guys who don't know what they want. That's a bad and wrong proposition for you. There's men who know where they're going, but they're not necessarily taking action on that front. So it's more like a wish. It's a beautiful wish, it's a nice dream, it's a pipe dream, but it's not a reality. You want to know that the guy that is at a great space right now, not the ideal space that he'll ever be because he's still growing, but in a decent space where he has the ability to give you time, energy, and offer something of value to your life just like you can on his, that he knows where he's headed, that the pace that he's headed has the same sense of urgency as your life. And the last one, that he's really taking action, that he's not just a smooth talker, that his actions match his intensity and his words. And if you can figure those things out through conversation, through conscious dating, through not having sex with him early on, because then you'll feel very attached to him most likely, and then you won't be able to observe and to be objective about these situations. If you can slow down, take the time to get to know him, as you get to know other men as well, then you have a chance of creating something sustainable where chemistry is not just the leading and only force between you and him, which is what happens with so many men and women today. There's such chemistry that's strong, but there's nothing, there's not a strong foundation of anything to make that chemistry last. You don't want to be in that situation. Hope this is helpful, insightful to you in some way. If it is, I'm going to ask you to do three things. Number one, click like or thumbs up on this video. Number two, subscribe to my channel. And if you hit the little bell, you'll be notified of new episodes. Thing number three, it's two parts. Part one of thing number three. If you want to take these concepts deeper and understand what it takes to enter the best relationship of your life so far, then on the first link on the description of this video, I've created a masterclass where you just click on the link, enter your name and email, and you'll be directed to this class that's absolutely free where you can learn more how to take these concepts deeper and start applying them today. The last part of my ask is, if you're listening to me right now, and you know who you are if this resonates with you. You've watched the videos, you've read the books, you've talked to friends, you've gone to therapy, none of that shit has worked. You know that you need more than whatever you've done so far to create the kind of relationship you want and to become the kind of woman that you want to become, then I might be able to help you. Second link on the description of this video will have an application where you can fill out the application. If I feel I can help you, my assistant will reach out and connect with you, and we'll have a conversation to figure out if we can be a fit, mutual fit to work together. Thank you so much for allowing me into your heart, into your home, for being courageous enough to listen to this, even though some of it may not be fun to listen to, but that you take it into your heart and make it real for you so that you can get exactly what you want.